Mendelblatt in the beautiful Nassau Yacht Club. Sun shining, very bright. Mark, you're one of the top sailors in this class, Olympic campaigner. You've been sailing with Brian Fati for a while, and you won the Bacardi Cup earlier this year, which is one of the main events in the Star. Just how on form do you feel that you guys are coming into this contest?
Well, we're not sure, to be honest. The Bacardi Cup was a big win for us. We had not sailed the boat together since the Olympics, so there's a good gap there. And we got stronger and stronger throughout the event, and we were feeling quite good at the end of the event. We finished very strong and won the regatta, and it was a great win for us. But we haven't sailed since then, and we're really uncertain of how it's going to be. We're confident in what we've got, our package with our boat and our sails, and we think that, you know, we're going to have a good crack at being one of the top teams here. But with that said, the fleet's very, very good. There's a lot of sailors coming in from outside classes, and they tend to do well usually in the beginning because they don't overthink it. And we'll see. This is a very talented field, so we're expecting to do well, but you never know.
Give us an insight into how you are going to do well in this little championship here. It's an experimental championship, but the kind of mental approach, the strategy, the tactical approach, kind of what's going to make the difference here?
Well, it is an interesting format, and I think it's going to prove to be a good one, because the last few races are the ones that really count, and it'll lend itself towards great media coverage and spectating. The first 3 days are going to be full fleet racing, long courses, and really just getting into the top 10 is the goal. It's all that matters. So in a way, if you're sailing well and you're comfortably in the top 10, the first 3 days are pretty much just kind of practice days to see what's going good and see what changes you can make to be better for the money races at the end. So we're going to try and sail conservatively, you know, not take ourselves out of the competition, and hopefully be one of the top 10 when it comes down to the final races, and be going quick at that point.
Brian, your crew tells me that, you know, one of your extraordinary abilities is your focus. He tells me that you're phenomenally focused all the way around the racetrack. You never kind of let go. Can you tell us a little bit about that and why?
Well, I think all the sailors, skippers and crews out here have that focus, and you need it to be competitive in this fleet. You know, I've been racing boats all my life, and I know that if you're not focused, that you don't have a chance. So you know, from start to finish, I really try and keep my head in the game and thinking about the things that are important, keeping the boat moving fast and considering the tactical options, and just trying to do my job as best as I can.
Last question, just on that boat speed, that going fast. Paul Kayard says possibly the secret here is going to be boat speed. Just what are a couple of tricks that really make these boats fly?
Well, you know, setup is very important. Getting the rig tuned correctly, and you know, having the confidence that you are set up for the right, you know, breeze, what you've got on that day. There's a lot of teams using different equipment here, different boats, different sails. So it'll be interesting to see who's going fast. But you know, we did a lot of development leading up to the Olympics. The settings and materials we used there in the Olympics proved to be good in the Bacardi Cup, and we're hoping that we're still very competitive with those settings. But you know, Paul is right, the boat speed is going to be the key here at this regatta, because we will be sailing longer courses, and you know, there's nowhere to hide. The teams that are fast are going to be the ones in front.